far and have done so much. For here with their music, they have created hope. But not without some homesickness. And we'll take care of that next on Primetime. Millions and millions of people who ride buses in China, you know that these were born in the USA.
Visa! 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 Visa!
The Pennsbury band is just about ready to head on home, knowing that what they felt over here at their age will become memories that last a lifetime. Their journey has been rich and fine, and will stay forever young.
We were all crying last night. Everybody had a big cry session right after the concert. Except for the guys. The guys are too macho. All the girls cried.
Are you kidding?
Well, I just thought it was really touching at the end, how everybody, we had a standing ovation and everything.
I tears came to my eyes.
I couldn't stop. It was just, I was in full uniform and I was crying as I was playing the last song.
As soon as the China flag came out, you see everybody just rise.
Stood up and clapped and it was like all over. It was all over.
We knew, we finally realized that we're here and we're leaving.
Are you sure you really want to go?
Yes, I miss my mom so much.
And there were mothers and fathers and friends who missed them and were anxiously awaiting their arrival here at Pennsbury High School at 1 o'clock in the morning. When finally the word came, they're here. Grothman, teacher and friend to so many here. Son of a gun if he doesn't come up with the perfect last words to our story.
It's like an impossible dream, and it all came true.
Organization of Tokyo, next on Primetime. Just recently, our Primetime crew made a surprising discovery in Japan. America is making money over there. It's no joke.
I like American things.
They really do. They really like our style. They like our medicine. They even like our big bad wrestlers, such as Bam Bam Bigelow. He made the trip from this arena in Cherry Hill, New Jersey, to the center ring here in Tokyo. But more than our wrestlers, the Japanese are mesmerized by our mouse. Welcome to Tokyo Disneyland, where mouse-eared munchkins do the boogaloo. Primetime crew stopped here on their way back from China. There they had covered the tour of the Bucks County Pennsbury High School band. For them and for us, it was an unforgettable experience. Their roller coaster ride through history and emotion, the band needed to lighten up before the long journey home. So on their way back to Bucks County, they stopped in Tokyo to perform. But also to play. Having fun? This may look like fun and games, but we are surprised to discover that this is the solution to a very serious problem, something with which Philadelphia is all too familiar. Tons and tons and tons of garbage. That's the problem. Where do you put it all? Tokyo put theirs into a landfill site. Disneyland official Toshihara Akiba tells us that.
If you had to come here about 20 years ago, you would be standing at the bottom of Tokyo Bay.
Once the Tokyo Land Company was out of the water, it decided to build an all-American playground for the hard-working Japanese.
It was our dream to make a leisure park where the entire family can enjoy. And it so happens that Disney people were looking at their first foreign venture, possibility of their first foreign venture.
A priest blesses the enterprise, and the heavy equipment moves in. Japan's first American castle is crowned, and by 1983 is complete. In other words, we're open for business. The crowds roll in. 10 million the first year. Every year brings in 10 million more.
It was our belief from the very beginning that the kind of entertainment which Disney provides goes beyond the nationality or cultural background, but the success has been beyond our imagination.
By 1988, Tokyo Disneyland is the nation's top tourist attraction.
And we had so far about 54 million people.
That is half the population of all of Japan coming to mingle with Mickey and his friends. We wanted to know, what is it about Disneyland that so enchants the Japanese? We asked tour guide Tatsuo Hagarara.
It seems like it's the land of the dream. So, you know, when I go out in Tokyo, there's so many people and so many buildings and so many, you know, every time it's busy. So we don't really have a fun, you know, enjoy. But if we come here, we can enjoy. And it's completely different world.
Maybe you will notice that all of the store signs of the stores, for example, are all written in English. This is to provide a foreign atmosphere for our Japanese people. We wanted our Japanese guests to feel as if they are taking a foreign trip.
Right down to the signs in English, this park is a perfect Disney World clone. All it needs is an old-fashioned American band to march right down Main Street.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, a special program reminder. At 11 a.m., Tokyo Disneyland will present the Pennsbury High School Marching Band.
The performance over, the band members and their chaperones make themselves right at home.
All right, where are we going first?
As our band members discovered there's a lot that's identical to Disney Park set up in America. The pirates still sing in English. But in Western land, the buffalo are bilingual. It is a small world where our American childhood fantasies are now becoming theirs. They're taking a grand tour of America without ever leaving Tokyo.
For us, the Disney represents the best in the United States, the attitude to look forward, think about tomorrow.
Tomorrow, there are some pretty hair-raising American exports that are due to arrive in Tokyo any day now. Knows where the breaks are. It's the Star Wars creator George Lucas coming to visit Tokyo, where he's made a deal with Mickey-san to bring Star Wars into Tomorrowland. The film mogul and the mouse. They're an odd couple who will be making some pretty powerful magic together, building bridges across two cultures. We're learning from each other. They showed us how to compete, but we're showing them how to have fun.
Disney is, like our dream.
Our Mickey, their dream, kind of makes you
proud, very proud.
Proud to say he was born and bred in the USA. These last few weeks have been busy ones for our primetime crew, especially in China. There was so much that happened and so little time to tell it. So in closing tonight, we'd like to take a little time to look and listen and remember the way that they were over there in the prime time of their lives.
This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever. Did you know that before you came into my life, some kind of miracle that I survived? Someday we will both look back and have to laugh. We lived through a lifetime and the aftermath. This is the time. To and so will I.